Hi there. So there was this day I saw a quote that says a mind once expanded can never return to its original size. And you know, it really got me thinking, if you really research, most of the most successful people are people that are constantly reading. I know that's why the saying goes that readers are leaders. Now, but have you ever been in a situation whereby you just finished reading a book and you know, a couple of days later or a week later, you can't even remember what you read? Honestly, it has happened to me a lot of times. And so I went ahead and started researching how can I read to retain it and also to even, you know, use it better. I mean, because as someone that does coaching and consulting, I need to read a lot of books, and I also need to apply those things that I read into the people that I'm working with. And so I came up across a concept, right? And I want to share that concept with you so that it can help you to read better. How to take notes for effective memorization. And you know, I learned that tip from Jim Quick. Now, if you know Jim Quick is the author of Limitless, and he really talks about the limitless capacity of the brain, of how you can expand your capacity of your brain. And so he said that it's actually very easy if you want to take notes better. So he calls it the capture and create method. And what he says is, it's pretty simple. If anytime you want to learn anything, you want to read a book, or you want to listen to a podcast, or you're listening to an audiobook, of which, you know, I listen to a lot of audiobooks, and I think that audiobooks is one of the ways that I'm able to keep up with the intensity of how much I want to read. Now, but sometimes you listen to an audiobook and then you forget. Now, one of the things he said was that, you know, if you don't, it takes 48 hours, right? It takes 48 hours for you to forget any new thing that you have learned, except if you do it in a certain way. So most times, everything that we learn in 48 hours, we forget it, except we do it in a way. Now, how do we do it? And that we're going to use this note-taking method. And so he says it's called the capture and create method, and it's very simple. All you have to do is to get a sheet of paper, right? So once you get the sheet of paper, divide the paper into two with a line. On the left side is the capture side. On the right side is the create side. Now, on the capture side, all you're doing is just capturing keywords, phrases, and ideas that pop up as you're reading or as you're listening. Now, the create side is when you now pick up those things that you have captured and create something. It's like this, right? Read with the aim to teach, even if you're not going to teach. But the honest truth is that the best way to learn something is to teach it. So if you're able to teach something, you are learning it for the second time, right? So read like as if you're going to teach. So when you capture on the left-hand side, you then create something like you want to teach somebody, like you want to share excerpts from a book. So let's say, for example, you read a particular book about a particular concept, you capture the ideas, and then on the create side, just, you know, write down things that you think you can use in case you have to teach. Once you do that, you'll be able to summarize. Now, but there are three steps that you need to take when you're capturing those notes. The first one is to think. While you're writing, right, while you're capturing those thoughts and you're doing all these things they're doing, you need to be thinking about, okay, how will this connect? Be asking yourself questions. How can I teach this? How can this be better used? You know, that kind of thing, right? And then the second one is you need to prioritize. So once you're able to identify all the things that you want to do, prioritize them, right? And then once you prioritize them, then you now index them. So how do you index them? It's by highlighting a few things. Once you prioritize the ones that are of priority, you index it. You know, you can use highlighters, you can use bold, italics, or you know, whatever you want to use. So I think that when you do that, you'll be able to retain more, and then you'll be able to capture the essence of what you have learned. One of the ways that I have been able to do that is for every time I read a book, I try to write a review. So when I capture, I'm capturing the important things that stuck out to me. When I'm creating, is I'm creating, what do I want to share? What's the most important thing that I've learned about that book that I want to share with others in sort of like in the form of a book review, right? And I think that if you do that, you'll see immense improvement in your ability to retain what you read and also to be able to implement it in everything you're doing. And as you go about doing, you know, reading the amazing books, and using these techniques, I want you to know that I believe in your capacity to grow and lead. Take care.